We have a very exciting panel here, a very diverse background of people coming sitting here in the panelists. We have Mr. Shrinivas Kunte, who is director of CFA Institute. We have Naushad Shaikh Saab, CFO. We have Fazal Ahed Saab, who is a fundraiser himself. And then similarly, the educational background experience all have been quite diversified and different from each other. So I'm very positive about the outcome that we are going to have in this session about the most important challenge that any business faces is how to raise finance, how to scale up. We have got ideas, we have got skills, but where the most important challenge comes is how to scale it up, how to get finance, and how to, you know, take this business further in its life cycle. That is the session we are going to have a discussion on today in this particular panel. And I would request each of you to please note down your questions after having listened to the panelists and ask as many questions as you wish to. The most important thing is that you should be asking questions so that we can benefit from their experience and knowledge as much as possible. Without that, this session is not going to be successful. So I'm requesting very humbly to all of you to please note down your questions and feel free to ask questions for your own business, for the experiences that you have had, and also for the challenges you might have heard through your from your business partners, from your friends, and so on and so forth. Now, we have a very open format here. So I'll be going to each one of the panelists here, asking them about the initial feedback on the subject that we have discussed yesterday also in this con call, and also about the theme that is there, how to raise finance for businesses, especially the MSMEs. So they will be, each panelist will be taking for a few minutes to share his initial thoughts. After that, we can have supplementary questions to, you know, understand more from what they might have said or what might be needing more explanation. And after that, we will be coming back to each of you for your own questions, which I can pose before the panelists. So that is the session. We have started on time. We will not go beyond our time that is allotted to us. And therefore, I request you all to be very attentive and open to ask questions. Now, coming to MSME, micro, small, and medium enterprises, the benefits are too obvious, especially for a country like India, where we say that 90% economy is informal and only 10% economy is actually formal. We have one of the largest number of companies listed, but that is, again, maximum is 7,000. Out of that, around 2,000 is not operating and not trading daily. So more than nearly 5,000 companies are traded. But we live in a country which has got more than 4 crore business units, industrial units. So the whole chunk of Indian economy, and which is the fourth largest in terms of purchasing power across the globe, is actually thriving on the backbone called micro, small, and medium enterprises. The largest chunk of employment comes from that. The largest chunk of export comes from that. The largest chunk of manufacturing comes from that. So that is the importance of the discussion that we are going to have today. But the biggest problem these units are facing is, as I said, how to raise finance, what are the means, what are the mechanisms, what are the conditions, how to pay them, when to pay them, how much is good to raise, and when it is good to raise. Because many a times it becomes a kind of game also between the innovator of the idea, the business runner, and the finance companies or venture capitalists. Many times they are called by derogatory name called vulture capitalists also. And there are people who have had very bad experience also. So we'll try to benefit from the experiences of the professionals and experienced people that we have here today. So with this very brief introduction, I would go to my each panelist, starting with Mr. Naushad. We have already shared some questions. So those things are there. 4-5 minutes, Naushad, is okay?
Yeah, that should be fine.
Okay, please. So we'll have 4-5 minutes of initial remarks by each panelist, and then we'll have supplementary round of question, and then we'll open to public. Please.
Right. So let me first take up the question on the challenges faced by MSMEs in financing. So in my view, the biggest challenge that the MSME face is twofold. One is lack of awareness, and second is the mindset issue. Let me explain what I mean. Okay, so barring some tech startups or first generation entrepreneurs, I've seen that many people don't envision big enough. There is not much strategic thinking as to how to take the business to the next level. So some of the people I keep meeting, they're extremely happy with the business that their father or forefathers have handed over to them. In fact, very interestingly, if you see their growth strategy, it is dependent on how much tax they're able to pay to the government. So unfortunately, they don't realize that in this scheme of things, they're actually borrowing funds from government, right? And we all know that borrowing from government is very, very expensive because there are hidden costs attached to it. So the hidden cost attached to it here is that it results into a weaker balance sheet, and most of the financiers don't touch upon these kind of businesses. That deprives them of taking the business to the next level, right? So I spoke about general awareness issue as well. So I think some of the people that I have met, surprisingly, they have taken high cost unsecured loans to finance their business. So that means that they're not even aware of some standard cheaper options that are available for financing, right? Every time you don't need to go and take a working capital or a big loan from the banks. There are various options available which can help you bridge the small time gap that we have in working capital. So that's the lack of awareness and networking that I was talking about. So on the other hand, if you take an angle from the financier standpoint, there's a lot of issue in relation to small and medium enterprises, right? So there is more cash transactions into the business, which they don't understand too much because there is lack of transparency potentially, or the accounting system or record keeping system is not proper. There is issue on compliances. Sometimes the basics of bookkeeping accounts, you know, is not even maintained on an accrual basis because that's how we look at the system of bookkeeping. So most of these traders or small enterprises keep the books on cash basis. So all of these are hindrances for the financier standpoint because they perceive a greater risk, because of which they don't give the money easily, but they ask for collaterals. And we all know the issues with collaterals, right? Because these kind of entrepreneurs don't have that kind of collaterals. That's why the bridge is never built in. But thanks to the new age technology that we are living in today, there are a lot of fintech companies who have come up with various products, whether it is based on website or app based, wherein you can go and easily apply for small time financing requirements, right? And they have used the technology to their advantage. For example, big data or analytics, AI, etc., artificial intelligence. So they are using all of this technology to be able to bridge the gap of small time finance requirements, and they're able to do that. And in fact, we all know that the government is doing a lot of things, including RBI opening up avenues for financing the MSMEs, realizing that, you know, it plays an important role in GDP and so on. Shariq bhai also mentioned about whether debt or equity, which is a classic question, right? So I think in my view, it largely depends on the stage of business that you are into, right? If you feel that the business has reached a stage where you can foresee the revenue coming in, where you have more predictability of revenues, where there can be profitability assurance, there can be cash generation assurance, until and unless the business reached a stage which in our business terminology we call it as business as usual or BAU, then taking a huge debt does not make sense to me, right? Because anyways you have taken a huge business risk. Why add another sword on your head of debt repayment, interest and so on? So rather you raise equity meaningfully and just focus on building the business and taking it to the next level, right? Additionally, I think banking financing, as I mentioned, it's not that you need to take a tool of all big ticket financing, but there are small ticket financing as well. So let me take a pause here and see other panelists if we have to say something.
Sure. Completely agree with whatever Naushad just said. Personally, good part of what I do goes into helping early stage companies or mid-sized companies raise capital. So I'm fairly familiar with the challenges that these companies face. I'm fairly familiar with the rigor that the investor looks at these companies when he's looking for a funding. But before I get into all that, let's take a step back and think of where do these companies stand when we are talking about MSME companies or we are talking about early stage companies. There are a few things that kind of define these companies. First of all, these companies are promoter driven. They are high on passion. More often than not, there will be a promoter, possibly promoter family, that's running this business. That also means that there's not enough management bandwidth for other activities. That also means that everything flows into the one man who's running the show, constraints. Now, constraint is something that I see in all these companies, whether it is a management bandwidth concern, constraint, whether it is a systems and policies constraint, because they do not have much of it, probably they do not have anything, whether it is a compliance issues, whether it is about a lack of any strategy, any future vision on where do they want to be, not now, not in the next 3 months, but after 3 years. So lack of planning constraint. Now, one side we have these constraints that every company of this side has. The other side you have to look at what are the options available when it comes to funding. Because till very recently, even the funding options available to them was quite limited, to be honest. The banks will always look at security, collateral, and that will be difficult for them to get. Unsecured lending, like Mr. Naushad just said, is very high cost. There are other avenues of financing, but lack of awareness, that's another constraint, does not allow them to reach out to those avenues of financing. Even if you go for equity funding, which is what I do on a regular basis, I realize that people are not familiar with how to go about it. They are not familiar with what are the pitfalls in equity funding. As a result, more often than not, I come across situations where somebody has taken an equity funding and landed in more trouble than what probably he would have been without that equity funding. When I'm talking about equity funding for these early stage companies, there are several types of funding options. People take some money from friends and family. People take some money from angel investors. Some of them go to some angel networks, like we have here Mumbai Angel Networks, Indian Angel Networks. There are several of them. Some of them who are slightly gone beyond that stage will go for a VC funding. What happens is, on one side, there is this entrepreneur who has all the passion, who knows about his business, who knows the dhanda. But the other side, there's a professional who only talks about his jargons, his terms. And in his eagerness to secure the funding, more often than not, I have seen these guys kind of agree to everything, like declining it. What they do not realize is that they may end up in more trouble, not that point of time. That point of time, they are pretty kicked that they have got the funding, right? What they do not know is 2 years down the line, 3 years down the line, when they go for the next round of funding, it's going to get back to them and hurt them. We'll talk about it in more detail as we go along, all right? So maybe we can have your view.
Thank you. First of all, I'm truly honored to be here with all of you. It's a wonderful audience. I guess all of you can hear me. Good afternoon. So I wanted to give you four perspectives, okay? I've got 5 minutes and four perspectives. There'll be an international perspective. There'll be a magic formula. And then there will be I wanted to just take forward what Mr. Naushad had said on awareness. And lastly, I wanted to make an offer. How many of you are students here? Okay, how many of you are aware of CFA Institute? just 2-3 hands, okay? So, you know, the international perspective now. You know, China, for CFA Institute, it's a US-based financial learning organization. But let me give you a brief history, a 20-second history. How many of you know Warren Buffett? Still more hands have come up. But Warren Buffett's guru was Dodd, okay? Dodd, Graham, Benjamin Graham and Dodd, these were two people on Wall Street. They started making money by investing in stocks. This was in 1920s. And then after that, you know, they said that when we want to invest in stocks, we don't want to, you know, take people, we want to also educate people to do the right thing. So they created this program called a CFA program. So that's the history of CFA program. The international perspective is as follows. See, India is a big kind of a growing country for CFA charter holders. But to give you, to put a contrast, if you look at China, more than 50% of the candidates who are coming in the CFA charter have a Chinese passport. The growth rate in China is exceeding, you know, all the scales everywhere, not just CFA, right? It's just growing because it's a bottom-up thing that's happening in China. Now, again, on the international perspective, if you see the economic growth in Germany, if you see the economic growth in Japan, you know, all of this is based on grassroots development, grassroots people coming in and saying, I want to create a Honda, I want to create a Sony. If you have not read the book, you should go and read the book called Made in Japan. It's written by the creator of Sony. So that's the international perspective. The second is the magic formula. The magic formula is to do with, you know, four things. It's called MEET. And MEET means M-E-E-T, MEET. Okay, so for you to raise money successfully, right, you need to have some understanding of each of these four things. What did I say? M-E-E-T, right? So M means marketing, E is for expenses, and it also means something to do with finance. So you should have some understanding of the expenses that you are going to incur and some understanding of finance. And the third thing is important, it is expertise. You need to have some expertise in something. And the last, but not the least, the most important thing is trust. Okay, so if you are ethical and if you can build trust, this magic formula will take you to places, it will raise money, it will give you success, endless success. Now the last thing that I wanted to make, offer. Okay, so the offer is, you know, I can be a small financier. Sorry, I missed the third thing. The third thing is about, you know, it's an incredible opportunity, it's a lifetime opportunity, especially for youngsters here. You know, the world of AI, the world of deep learning. Now you can go out today without any cost of capital, you can start programming as long as you have got internet and you can start selling yourself. You can create incredible value, right? You don't need to have capital. So we are moving towards a world where how many of you know Facebook? Facebook, just three hands? Wow, I'm surprised. So Facebook is a data company, right? Do they need any capital? When they started, they did not. They just needed brains and hard work. That's how they started. So the capital requirement in today's world has just collapsed. Okay, so that's the third thing. And the last thing is the offer that I make. If you want to create a small organization, right? I'm here to fund you in a very small way. And if you're looking to do that with me, you know, I've got something that is ready to be used. And Mr. Aslam, who's been supporting me in this, you know, will be happy to collaborate. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you very much. एक चीज मैं और जानना चाह रहा हूँ आप लोगों से, इंग्लिश में डिस्कशन सही चल रहा है या हम लोग मिक्स ज़बान भी इस्तेमाल करें? मिक्स, दैट इज़ व्हाट आई फेल्ट लाइक. हाँ, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ठीक है, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली वी आर हियर फॉर यू. इफ अगर हिंदी में आपका काम चलता है तो भी हम यहाँ उस हिसाब से हैं. मुझे थोड़ा एहसास हुआ इसलिए मैंने पूछा आपको. बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग राउंड हुआ पहला हमारा, जहाँ पे तीनों पैनलिस्ट ने हमारे अपने अपने नज़रिए से बात की. नौशाद साहब का जहाँ कहना था कि लैक ऑफ इमेजिनेशन, जब हम बिज़नेस शुरू करते हैं तो हमें खुद अंदाज़ा नहीं होता कि ये 10-20 साल भी चलेगा या उससे कम चलेगा, और उसके हिसाब से हमारी प्लानिंग नहीं होती है। और इसके साथ हमारे फजल साहब ने ये कहा उसी पॉइंट को आगे बढ़ाते हुए कि फिर हम जब हम इमेजिन नहीं करते तो उसके हिसाब से प्लानिंग नहीं होती, और जब प्लानिंग नहीं होती और अपने बिज़नेस के बारे में भी उतनी जानकारी नहीं होती है तो अक्सर हम जो है गलत फैसले करते हैं या गलत टाइम पे फैसले होते हैं, जिसकी वजह से वो बिज़नेस की पोटेंशियल को हम इस्तेमाल नहीं कर पाते और बजाय मसले का हल होने के, सॉल्व करने के, हम भी एंड अप क्रिएटिंग अनदर काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम फॉर आर सेल्फ। और इसी पॉइंट को आगे बढ़ाया श्रीनिवास साहब ने कि जहाँ पर उन्होंने आपको एक मंत्रा भी दिया कि मीट आपको थोड़ी सी मार्केटिंग आनी चाहिए, थोड़ा सा आपको एंटरप्राइज़ के बारे में और आपको एक्सपेंसेस के बारे में, अपनी एक्सपर्टाइज के बारे में, और आपको ट्रस्ट, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है ट्रस्ट, क्योंकि अगर आप देखेंगे ख़ास तौर से जो MSMEs का है कि इनको सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये होती है जब ये मार्केट में जाते हैं, जो इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं वो उनको पता नहीं होता है कि ये जिस बिज़नेस में है उसकी इंफॉर्मेशन हमारे पास नहीं है, जिसको हम इंग्लिश में या इकोनॉमिक्स में इंफॉर्मेशन एसिमेट्री कहते हैं। जब मैं आपको फाइनेंस करने जाता हूँ या आप मेरे पास आते हैं फाइनेंस के लिए, तो मुझे पता नहीं होता है कि आपके बिज़नेस की एक्सपर्टाइज में मुझे इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं है, आप मुझे सही से रिपोर्ट करेंगे कि नहीं करेंगे, और आपको ये डर होता है कि कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं कि आपका बिज़नेस बना बनाया मैं कैपिटल प्रोवाइडर जो है आपका टेक ओवर कर लेगा। तो दोनों तरफ एक इन्फॉर्मेशन गैप होता है, एक लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट होता है। फाइनेंशियर से वो डरा हुआ होता है लेकिन मजबूर होता है उसके पास आने के लिए, और फाइनेंशियर भी डरा होता है कि मेरा पैसा डूब ना जाए। तो एक पॉइंट ऐसा आता है जहाँ पर हम ट्रस्ट की बात करते हैं, और वो ट्रस्ट जो है बहुत अहम होता है कि हाउ टू ब्रेक दैट आइस, हाउ टू विन दैट ट्रस्ट। और ये एक आर्ट भी है और एक ये एक तरह के जो है आपको एक स्किल भी है। आर्ट इन द सेंस के यू नो यू नीड टू हैव कॉन्फिडेंस इन योर पार्टनर्स, यू नीड टू डेवलप दैट स्किल। अगर आप इस चीज़ को नहीं कर पा रहे हैं तो शायद बिजनेस में आप लंबा टिक नहीं पाएंगे। आप जो सामान बेचते हैं आपका खरीदने वाला कॉन्फिडेंट होना चाहिए, आप जिनसे माल लेते हैं वो सप्लायर आपका कॉन्फिडेंट होना चाहिए, जिससे आप फाइनेंस लेते हैं वो लोगों को आपको पे ट्रस्ट करना चाहिए। और ट्रस्ट तभी होगा जब आप दूसरों पे ट्रस्ट करना सीखें। ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है कि मैं आप पे भरोसा न करूं और आप मुझ पे भरोसा करें, ये मेरा मुगालता हो सकता है, मेरी गलती हो सकती है कि मैं किसी पे भरोसा नहीं करता हूं, बड़ा स्मार्ट हूं और लोग मुझ पे भरोसा करते हैं। ये बहुत ही इन्फेक्शस होता है। व्हेन यू लव अदर पार्टी लव्स यू, व्हेन यू ट्रस्ट अदर पार्टी टेंड टू ट्रस्ट यू, वो भोला भी समझती थी कहती यार इसको धोखा नहीं दो। तो दिस इज समथिंग वेयर आई एम गोइंग टू कम टू माई यू नो पैनलिस्ट एज विद द नेक्स्ट राउंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन। वन मोर थिंग विच इज़ वेरी ऑब्वियस अबाउट इंडियन पर्टिकुलर इंडियन मार्केट इज़ अबाउट द हेट्रोजेनिटी। अगर आप पूरे इंडिया का देखें सो इट इज़ वेरी हेट्रोजेनस फ्रॉम ईच अदर। प्रोडक्ट बहुत डिफरेंट हैं, कल्चर बहुत डिफरेंट है। यूपी में जाकर के लोग कहते हैं भाई नहीं यूपी वाले यहाँ आगे बिजनेस करें, लेकिन वहाँ नहीं। बट देर आर स्ट्रेंथ्स देयर ऑल्सो, देर आर स्ट्रेंथ्स इन गुजरात, देर आर डिफरेंट फीचर्स इन महाराष्ट्र एक्सेट्रा। सो इंडियन मार्केट इज़ वेरी हेट्रोजेनस, एक चीज़। दूसरा जो चैलेंज आता है वो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का आता है, चाहे वो फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हो चाहे वो सॉफ्ट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हो। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्लोबल इंडिया और वन इंडिया, बट विद इन इंडिया देर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इंडियाज इन टर्म्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज, इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, इन टर्म्स ऑफ एबिलिटी टू समथिंग। सो इन सारी चीज़ों को ध्यान में रखते हुए आई एम कमिंग टू यू ऑल के जो MSMEs हैं, कौन सी चीज़ें ऐसी हैं जो कि आपको लगता है कि कॉमन हो सकती हैं, जो एवरी MSME इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ विच एरिया इट कम्स फ्रॉम, जो उनको बेसिक चीज़ों को रखना होगा ताकि वो अगर आज नहीं तो कम से कम एक साल के बाद, दो साल के बाद जब वो फंडिंग के लिए, जब वो नेक्स्ट इसके ग्रोथ के लिए जाना चाहें तो उनके पास वो बेसिक फाउंडेशन तैयार हो, सो दैट इट हेल्प देम रीच आउट टू अ मार्केट सेगमेंट। सो फजल साहब आपसे शुरू करेंगे and then we'll take your bites from everyone.
So that's a good question to begin with. So every company has to be do some homework, has to do some groundwork to be ready for the funding. And I'm talking about funding in general, whether it is equity, debt, any kind of a funding. One is that you need to be very, very clear about what you're offering. There are many companies today, and you'll be surprised, that who are not even sure of their main offering because they are not sure about monetization. There are people who are doing certain services without making money, and just like many of these tech companies, they believe that at the right time, we will find out how to make money. But believe me, if you are running a business and you have to run it for a sustainable period of time, so main ek do saal ki baat nahi kar raha hoon, I'm talking about for a longer period of time, you have to work with a plan that even if, let's say, today you are not profitable, tomorrow, next year, sometime you have to be profitable, and there has to be a path towards that profitability. Aap aisa nahi kar sakte ho ki main agle 3 saal tak profitable nahi hoonga and voila, fourth year I'll be profitable. It never happens like that. And you have to have enough evidence in place ki main jo bol raha hoon woh sach hai. So what is very important at this level is to bring out or create the credibility in the mind of the investor. This credibility comes from some of the data that you share. Ki jaise maine kaha ki pichle saal humne itna turnover kiya tha, meri ye cost thi, meri ye profitable thi. Ab dekho bhai, meri cost aise aise change ho rahi hai. My margins are improving. I may not be profitable, I may be profitable. But I have to have a business plan. I have to have a steady state scenario. And I have to work towards that. Because only when you do that, then the other party also get comfortable and have confidence in your numbers. That is also about what you mentioned sometime about ethical and trust. Because many a times what happens is, when, and I have seen it, people go out to the investors, they talk about all kind of numbers, bolne mein kya jaate hai. But please remember that whatever you say can boomerang on you, because tomorrow the same guy is going to dig into your books, he is going to ask you very uncomfortable questions. So you are far better off ki abhi aapke paas jo situation hai aap wo bataye, aur aap bataye shuru mein hi bata de, aur aap bataye ki agar ye situation is not really a very congenial, very good kind of a situation, then you have to be upfront and forthright and tell him ki bhai agle 6 mahine mein main ye karne wala hu. This situation, if it is not good, and I'm particularly only talking about the negative side of the situation, because if everything is hunky-dory, you don't need any support, right? So if the situation for whatever reason is not good, these are the reasons. I mean, I have come across so many companies, you know, ne bola ki yaar jab GST shuru hui to hamara to band baj gaya. Ek do mahine tak sab log hil gaye the, 6 mahine tak sab log hil gaye the. I think people are coming back on track right now. Yeah, demonetization hua, so people suffered for some that period, but they are back on track. So is tarah ki agar koi issue hai, aap bata do, so that I know ki current numbers do not necessarily reflective of your future. But there's no point in hiding. You have to have your ethics in place, you have to be transparent to the investor, you have to build the confidence, then only he will also trust you. There are no two ways about it. Would you like that?
Yeah. I would like to stress upon the business model point. Of course, Fazal has touched upon some elements of it. When you talk about business model, it's not only about a spreadsheet in Excel which shows some initial losses and then huge jump in profits. It's about how you're solving a business problem. What market needs you are catering to, right? Sometimes people, the young generation, hot blood, they come up with a lot of innovative ideas. But for them, sometimes technology comes first. They believe in technology, that this technology can solve any problem. But the key question to answer is, what kind of problems are we solving for? What is the market demand for it? What is the need gap analysis behind it? So how do we take that into a profitable business, right? So there can be a gap in some area. But if you offer some product, people may not be willing to pay a price. So what kind of value are bringing in to address that need gap, and how this can evolve in future, right? So you also, and Shariq was talking about market dynamics in India, but a lot of places market is not limited to the limited geography that we live into. So we have to open our horizon and see the entire world as a market. So if you say that there is nobody who is a competition to the product that I am bringing in, it's unbelievable, right? Because in the world, somebody else would have already cracked the same problem. Maybe slightly differently, but it may be similar. So those are the things that we need to keep in mind. And you know, sometimes I think this is a dilemma that most of the entrepreneurs feel, right? Because they are into a stage where they cannot afford, finance professionals. So they have to go on their own. So at that point of time, they need to familiarize themselves with a lot of financial aspects. You know, how the business model works, what are the growth drivers, what are the levers for increasing your revenue, how much it is based on volume growth, how much it is based on rate growth, what kind of markets you're going to, you know, capture initially, how the scale is going to go up. And more importantly, people also need to understand what is the cost structure, right? And in my company, our board keeps saying that costs are like fingernails. You need to keep cutting it every week at least, right? So those are some of the disciplines that we need to put it in our business DNA. If you don't do that, there will always be pressure on pricing. The cost will keep going up. There will always be pressure on margin, right? It's not only about scale. There are other drivers to increase profitability as well. So all of that thinking has to be brought into the business model. And one of the things that I feel is that when a lot of entrepreneurs go and talk to investors, they don't prepare enough, right? Because there are standard frequently asked questions by investors. There are reasons behind those standard questions, because those are important for investors to see that their money actually will turn into, you know, more returns. So I think people need to get familiar to those questions. A couple of examples I can give is, for example, what are the entry barriers, right? You are saying that your product is unique. You might, you know, want to launch this product and think that you are the only player who's going to, you know, win in the space. But there may be other players who can come in and exceed what you're doing already. So what is the barriers that you're putting in into picture, right? In addition to that, you know, sometimes what happens is you go on a standalone basis and meet the investors. But investors are also looking at beyond the entrepreneurs as to, because they are investing in a business, not necessarily only in the entrepreneurs. So you need to ensure that showcasing that you are not just a product head, you are actually a leader, you will be able to run a business. For that, you need to hire the best of the talent. You need to, you know, run the shop more effectively and efficiently. So your DNA of the fact that you're not just a tech geeky, but you are a leader who can lead people, who can collaborate with multiple stakeholders, showcasing that is extremely important when you're building a trust and equation with the investors.
Thank you. Very insightful discussion so far. मैं वापस वही फॉर्मूला के तरफ जाना चाहता हूँ. MEET आपको याद आ रहा है ना? So MEET में से आप अभी E को पकड़ लेना. ओके, कौन से E को पकड़ोगे? एक्सपेंसेस. तो एक्सपेंसेस से पहले मैं एक्सपर्टीज पे जाऊंगा, ठीक है? तो आप लोग सब मुंबई से हो? ओके, तो मैं तो एक गांव है खोपोली नाम का, उस गांव से हूं मैं. जब मैं सातवीं आठवीं में था तब कोई गणित का प्रॉब्लम आता था, तो गणित का प्रॉब्लम आता था वो बोलते थे, अरे ये तो सबसे तेज पूरे जग में ये सबसे तेज है, इनसे पूछ लेना. तभी ना गूगल था, ना याहू था, ना इंटरनेट था. पर अभी के हालात बदल गए हैं. तो एक्सपर्टीज में आपको ये देखना है कि आप कितने एक्सपर्ट हो. आप बैटिंग करते हो तो आप अजहरुद्दीन की तरह के जैसे हो, या सचिन तेंदुलकर के जैसे हो, या अजिंक्य रहाणे हो. आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि लोकल मैक्सिमा जो बोलते हैं, लोकल मैक्सिमा और ग्लोबल मैक्सिमा. लोकल मैक्सिमा मतलब आप सपोज आप एक दरी में रहते हो, राइट, वैली में रहते हो, तो आपको लगता है कि यही हिमालय है, यही सबसे बड़ा पर्वत है. पर आप जब उस पर्वत पे जाते हो तो आपको लगता है कि अरे नहीं, इससे और बड़ा है. तब जब आपको समझेगा आपकी औकात क्या है, आपकी एक्सपर्टीज क्या है, तब आपको फिर समझेगा कि भाई मुझे इस फील्ड में रहना है कि नहीं रहना है. और उस फील्ड में अगर आपको रहना है तो फिर आपको फिर एक्सपेंसेस की तरफ भी देखना पड़ेगा. आपने तय कर दिया कि मुझे इसी फील्ड में रहना है, फिर आपको समझ में आ गया कि मुझे इस फील्ड में रहना है तो इसमें डिमांड भी है तो मैं ये करूंगा. अगर डिमांड ही नहीं है तो फिर उस आपके एक्सपर्टीज से कुछ फायदा नहीं होने वाला है. आपको और वो डिमांड कहाँ तक है, क्योंकि साहब ने क्वेश्चन किया था कि आपको कोई भी एमएसएमई को हर स्टेज में वो मॉडल कैसे ऊपर लेके जाना है। तो अगर आपके पास एक्सपर्टीज है और डिमांड भी है तो फिर आप ऊपर जा सकते हो, नहीं तो फिर आपको आपका आपका नज़रिया बदलना पड़ेगा। एक एग्जांपल देता हूं मैं, अभी आपने देखा है कि इंडिया में 3-4 ही बड़े बड़े ब्रांड्स हैं, वो ब्रांड्स कंज्यूमर ब्रांड्स कहलाते हैं। तो कंज्यूमर बी टू सी बिजनेसेस जो बोलते हैं, बिजनेस टू कंज्यूमर, बहुत ही डिफिकल्ट है। साहब ने इसका जिक्र किया था कि इंडिया इज अ वेरी डाइवर्स कंट्री, हर तरह के लोग हैं, 40 किलोमीटर में लोगों का लोग जैसे बात करते हैं वो भी बदल जाता है। तो ऐसे कंट्री में आपको अगर स्केल करना है तो आपको ये समझना पड़ेगा कि बिजनेस टू कंज्यूमर करना बहुत ही मुश्किल है। तो कौन से बिजनेस सक्सेस होते हैं, आपने देखा है डिलीवरी बॉयज का बिजनेस बहुत सक्सेसफुल हो रहा है, क्यों हो रहा है, क्योंकि वो किससे कनेक्ट कर रहा है, उनकी जो सैलरी है डिलीवरी बॉय की सैलरी जो है, वो सैलरी देने वाला जो बंदा है और वो सर्विस जो देने वाला बंदा है उसमें मैचिंग है। पर अगर आपने ये ट्राई किया कि आपने सपोज रेस्टोरेंट डाल दिया, और आपने रेस्टोरेंट डाल दिया तो अभी वो जो रेंटल दोगे रेस्टोरेंट का, तो रेंटल जो आप पैसा एक्सपेंसेस जा रहे हैं आपके, वो एक्सपेंसेस है फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड के एक्सपेंसेस है, पर आप सर्विस दे रहे हो आम आदमी को जिसको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 200-300 रुपया एक लंच के लिए दे सकता है वो। तो ये जो मिसमैच है इसकी भी समझ आनी पड़ेगी। और लास्ट आप दोनों ने जिक्र किया उसका कि एथिक्स, तो एथिक्स जो है आपको एथिक्स कब आएंगे, जब आपको एक्सपर्टीज आएगा। अगर आपको एक्सपर्टीज है तो आपको गलत करने की ज़रूरत ही नहीं है। तो अगर आपके पास और एथिक्स अगर नहीं रहेगा तो फिर आपका बिजनेस ही नहीं स्केल होगा, आप झूठ बोलते जाओगे। साहब ने इसका जिक्र किया था कि अकाउंटिंग का जीएसटी और डीमोनेटाइजेशन। आपको मैं एग्जांपल देता हूँ, हमारी कंपनी एक कार ड्राइवर को हायर करती है, तो उसका जो मार्जिन है उसका मार्जिन है जीएसटी। तो उसने जो तय किया कि मैंने ये कार का धंधा चालू करता हूँ और वो टैक्स नहीं भर रहा है, ठीक है, उसको लगता है कि ठीक है कोई देख नहीं रहा है मैं टैक्स नहीं भर रहा हूँ, उसको ये भी समझ नहीं है कि ये जो मैं कर रहा हूँ अनएथिकल कर रहा हूँ। पर प्रॉब्लम ये हो गया कि जब जैसे जैसे टैक्स वाले लोग पूछेंगे टैक्स दे दो, तैसे उसका तो वैसे उसका बिजनेस अनसक्सेसफुल हो जाएगा। तो उसने क्या गलती की, उसको लगा मैं एक्सपर्ट हूँ इसमें, उसको लगा मेरे एक्सपेंसेस इतने हैं, अनएथिकल चीज़ें चालू की। पर अभी वो बिजनेस ऊपर जाने वाला है क्या, नहीं जाने वाला, क्योंकि उसकी बिजनेस की जो डिमांड है वो उसको मार्जिन ही नहीं है तो कैसे ऊपर जाएगा। थैंक यू,
एक्साइटिंग थिंग। मैं आपको बीच में बताता भी चलूं कि इसी ऑडियंस में आपके पास फाइनेंशियल्स भी बैठे हैं, अगर आपका बिजनेस मॉडल अच्छा है तो आपको फाइनेंशियल्स ढूंढ लेना चाहिए, और ऐसे लोग हैं जो अच्छे बिजनेस की तलाश में बैठे हुए हैं, ठीक है। तो सिर्फ यहाँ बात वाले लोग नहीं है, पैसे वाले लोग भी बैठे हुए हैं, जरा ध्यान से बैठिएगा आप लोग, एक चीज़। दूसरे बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट श्रीनिवास साहब ने बताया, बहुत सारे हम लोग ये भी सोचते हैं, दिमाग में बात नहीं आती कि ये भी एथिकल है कि हमें एज ए सिटीज़न हमारी जिम्मेदारी होती है हमारे कंट्री की तरफ, हमारी सोसाइटी की तरफ, हम पे टैक्स को पे करें। बहुत सारे लोग सोचते हैं कि हमने लिया क्या है जो हम पे करें, वो भी एक तरह की हमारी सोच में कमी है। हम सड़कों पर चलते हैं, बसेस का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, ट्रेन्स का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि हमने बस का किराया दे दिया तो पूरे बस की जो है कॉस्ट मीट हो गई, कोई ना कोई है जो उसको पे करके हमें उस रेट पर प्रोवाइड कर रहा है। तो बहुत सारी चीज़ें ऐसी हैं जो हम दिन रात अवेल करते हैं और ये समझते हैं कि हमें गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से क्या मिल रहा है कि हम बहुत ट्रांसपेरेंट होकर टैक्स पे करें। ये हो सकता है क्योंकि सब लोग इसी तरह सोचते हैं, तो इसलिए जो है पूरे देश का नुकसान होता है, और देश का क्या नुकसान होगा, उस सोसाइटी का ही नुकसान होता है, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली इट इज़ द सोसाइटी दैट पेज फॉर एवरीथिंग इन द लॉन्ग रन। तो हम अगर रिस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन हैं, जिस तरह से हम इंडिविजुअली रिस्पॉन्सिबल हैं उसी तरह से हमारी कॉर्पोरेट भी रिस्पॉन्सिबल हो, तो वी कैन क्रिएट अ बेटर फ्यूचर फॉर आवरसेल्फ एंड फॉर आवर कंट्री। टाइम कम है क्योंकि मुझे पब्लिक में भी जाना है, इसलिए बहुत शॉर्ट बाइट मैं एक लेता चलूँगा आप लोगों से कि कॉमन मिस्टेक्स क्या होती हैं जो एक बिजनेसमैन किसी के पास अप्रोच करता है, कुछ पॉइंट्स आपने रखे हैं, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी कुछ पॉइंट्स ऐसे हैं कि जो एक गलती है जो कि उसको फिर पीछे ढकेल देती है या उसको उसके दरवाजे बंद कर देती है, तो कौन सी कॉमन मिस्टेक्स आपको लगती हैं कि जो हमें आम तौर से चाहे किसी बिजनेस में हो, माइक्रो में हो, स्मॉल में हो, मीडियम में हो या आगे चल के हो, जो गलतियां हमें हमारे फ्यूचर प्रॉस्पेक्ट से, अपॉर्चुनिटीज से हमें पीछे की तरफ ले जाती हैं, व्हाट आर दोज मिस्टेक्स एंड हाउ कैन वी बेस्ट अवॉइड दैट टू वेट। सो थोड़ी थोड़ी बाइट आप कहें।
श्योर। सो कॉमन मिस्टेक्स, पहला तो ये होता है कि आप तैयार नहीं हो जब आप फंडिंग के लिए जा रहे हो। व्हेन आई से तैयार नहीं हो, आप तैयार नहीं हो बिकॉज यू हैव नॉट क्रिएटेड इनफ अवेयरनेस अबाउट व्हाट यू नीड, यू हैव नॉट क्रिएटेड इनफ अवेयरनेस अबाउट योर बिजनेस, योर वैल्यू प्रोपोजिशन, योर मार्केट। इसलिए कि आप ये याद रखो कि आपको लगता है आप सब चीज़ जानते हो अपने बिजनेस के बारे में, सामने वाला इज अ थर्ड पार्टी, ही हैज़ टू आस्क यू ईच एंड एवरीथिंग एंड ही एक्सपेक्ट्स एन आंसर फ्रॉम यू। आज मैं कोई बिजनेस खड़ा करता हूँ और मुझे कुछ कस्टमर्स मिल गए और मुझे लगता है कि ये बहुत बड़ा बिजनेस है, लेकिन सामने वाले ने दुनिया देखी है। सो यू हैव टू बी रेडी टू आंसर हिज क्वेश्चंस विद नंबर्स, विद डेटा एंड नॉट जस्ट अबाउट यू विद योर गट फील। सो दैट्स वन। सेकेंड इज आपकी कंपनी के डिटेल्स, नंबर्स, ये सब आप बता सकते हो। थर्ड आई विल से वेरी कॉमन मिस्टेक दैट पीपल डू इज अबाउट टाइमिंग ऑफ द रिजल्ट। Either they go for the raise up too early, or even if they go at some time, they ask for much more than what they really need. So the results can be only two. If you ask for more than, first, if you have gone too early, you are sent back, it's like you are not ready. And the second scenario, where you have asked for more than probably what you can chew, तो होता यह है कि सामने वाला या तो आपको देने से मना कर देता है, या अगर देता भी है, एंड इफ इट इज अबाउट इक्विटी, याद रहे कि इक्विटी इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ ऑल्सो डाइल्यूशन विच कम्स फ्रॉम वैल्यूएशन। आपको लेना था 20 करोड़, आपने मांगा 50 करोड़, कोई शायद आपको 50 करोड़ दे भी दे, लेकिन जो आपकी डाइल्यूशन होगी वो बहुत ज़्यादा होगी कंपेयर टू व्हाट इट वुड हैव बीन इफ यू हैड जस्ट टेकन द मनी दैट यू नीडेड फॉर दिस। So these are the some of the common mistakes that I see on a very, very regular basis.
Mere saab se, I think all of us should study and understand what options are available, right? Sometimes for whatever peer pressure or social pressure, we just go after one instrument. But before that, we should study what are the other options available. So I'm sure for any problem, there are multiple solutions. So financing is also not an exception to that. The other thing is, when we talk about equity, etc., let me also give an example. Suppose you have bootstrapped a company and you are, say, 1 or 2 years away from an institutional round, and you are seeking funding from, say, either friends, families, angels, or somebody else. There are some instruments available. For example, in the US, there is something called as Simple Agreement for Future Equity. It's called SAFE. Which means that when you raise money from these set of people, you wouldn't need to assign a particular valuation. The valuation will be attached to the institutional financing round that will happen after a year or 2 years. And the valuation will be, say, a discount of 20%, 30%, whatever is the amount. And this kind of instrument is becoming popular in India under the color of convertible notes. So what I'm saying is that there are options available, so you just need to watch out. The other thing that I would stress upon is the color of money, right? While quantum or amount wise money is the same, but the grayness of the color is different from which person or which investors you get it, and there are conditions attached to it. So you need to also study at what terms this money is coming into you. I've seen some people who just focus on getting the money, right? They don't understand the anti-dilution clauses, they don't understand the drag clauses, etc. But those are also equally important, because if they're not important at the time of receiving money, but in your day-to-day life, how you run the business, what kind of obligations you have towards the investors, those play a critical role, and sometimes it can be really distractive. So it's better to keep it simple and minimize the distraction in business so that you can build the business to the next level.
Thank you. So if I were to pick, agar ek hi cheez pick karni hai to main trust ko pick karunga MEET mein se, because aap aisi cheez hi karoge, ethical cheez hi karoge jab aapke paas expertise ho, nahi to dusri cheez karoge hi nahi, right? So trust is supreme. Aap kahin pe bhi jaate ho, kisi ne likha hai ki aap, suppose yahan pe abhi traffic jam tha yahan aane mein, वो ट्रैफिक जाम था क्योंकि कोई अनएथिकल नहीं, इसलिए ट्रैफिक जाम था कि किसी ने अनएथिकल चीज़ें की हुई है इसलिए मुझे आज दिक्कत हुई, या किसी को भी दिक्कत होती है ट्रैफिक जाम में या क्राउडेड बसेस में या आपका जेब काटने में. तो ये आप ये सोचिए कि आप ऐसी चीज़ करो, आपने अगर पक्का कर दिया, ऐसे सपोज एक थियोरेटिकल एक्सपेरिमेंटल वर्ल्ड है जिसमें वो जो ये जो आदमी है वो बोलता है कि नहीं मैं यही चीज़ करूँगा जो एथिकल है वही करूँगा, और हर आदमी ने ऐसा तय किया एथिकल है, तो किसी को भी कुछ भी दिक्कत नहीं होगी, और वो हर आदमी ऐसा ही चीज करेगा जिसमें उसको एक्सपर्टीज हो, बराबर है ना? तो फिर आपको दिक्कत ही नहीं हो जाएगी. और अगर दूसरी चीज अगर कुछ बोलनी है हो मुझे, तो एक्सपर्टीज आपको देखना है और उसके लिए अवेयरनेस करना है आपको. न्यूज़पेपर कितने लोग पढ़ते हो यहाँ पे? सिर्फ चार, ज्यादा हाथ नहीं है ऊपर, आप शायद फोन में बिजी हो, बट फोन में भी आजकल आता है, डेटा आता है. आपको ना इंडियन न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ने हैं, पर आपको सारे न्यूज़पेपर्स पढ़ने हैं. आपको चाइनीज न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना है, पाकिस्तानी न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना है, फाइनेंशियल टाइम्स पढ़ना है, न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स पढ़ना है. अलग अलग लोग अलग अलग विचार लेके आते हैं, और अगर आपको आपने इस विचारों को देखा नहीं तब आप आगे नहीं जाओगे.
थैंक यू. फाइनल राउंड मेरी तरफ से अभी एक एक मिनट प्लीज. एक चीज़ जो अक्सर मैं महसूस करता हूँ, कंट्री इज यंग, वी ऑल नो अबाउट 60% आर पॉपुलेशन इज यंग. MSME बहुत सारी हैं, या ग्रेट मेजोरिटी ऑफ MSMEs आर फैमिली ओन बिजनेसेस. अब वहाँ पे फादर है, फादर की स्टाइल डिफरेंट है, बच्चा नए इकोनॉमी में, नए दौर में, नए टूल्स के साथ पैदा हुआ है. फादर को तो अब व्हाट्सएप की आदत पड़ रही है, बच्चे को पैदाइशी व्हाट्सएप की आदत पड़ी हुई. तो एक पूरे बिजनेस मॉडल में एक तरह से डाइकोटोमी क्रिएट होती है. बाप समझता है कि मैंने जो किया वही स्टाइल है, बच्चा समझता है कि मैं सफोकेट करता है. अब वो अपने फैमिली में ही जो है एक तरह का टेंशन होता है कि बिजनेस को आगे ले जाएं या पीछे ले जाएं. एक चीज़ दूसरे बिजनेस ये है कि बहुत सारे बिजनेस हमारे ऐसे हैं जो डाइंग बिजनेस हैं. बच्चा नए बिजनेस को करना चाहता है और बाप कहता है नहीं, पुराने को मैं कर रहा हूँ क्योंकि मैं चार जनरेशन से ये बिजनेस कर रहा हूँ, तुम इसी को करो. तो घर में कैपेसिटी है लेकिन एक तरह का है कि तुम्हें यही करना है और उसी तरीके से करना है जैसे मैं बता रहा हूँ. और बच्चा जो है एक नए इन्वायरमेंट में आया हुआ है, वो न्यू इकोनॉमी की तरफ जाना चाहता है, वो न्यू प्रोडक्ट की तरफ जाना चाहता है, उसके एस्पिरेशंस डिफरेंट हैं. इस तरह के डाइकोटोमी में आप लोगों के हिसाब से क्या होना चाहिए, कैसे हैंडल करें? बिकॉज फैमिली इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, रिस्पेक्टिंग फादर इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट हाउ टू कन्विंस और हाउ टू नेविगेट थ्रू दोज काइंड ऑफ चैलेंजिंग. वन मिनट ईच प्लीज.
So I will say that, and I have seen this situation many a times, not once but many a times. Some of these situations, if there is no resolution, leads to an M&A kind of a situation where the father finally decides to sell his company. Lekin ek acha solution ye hota hai, jo ki maine kafi logon ko karte dekha hai, ki that they allow their son to do whatever he wants. Because the son also, we are not talking about a teenager or a young child, is also reached some stage. The son runs it for some times, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, whatever it is. If it is successful, he runs it forever. Then probably the next venture is better than what the father was doing. And if it is not, the son himself reconciles ki isse acha to main ghar ka business chalata hu. And I have seen them coming back.
Thank you.
I think mere hisab se end of the day, the parents have to realize that if there is no inherent passion, it's very difficult to run a business. If their son or daughter is not too much passionate about running the family business, the freedom has to be given to them to do what they want, because only the passion can take them to the greater heights. So that's what I would say.
Yeah, I'll just keep going back to trust and ethics. आपने अगर आपकी personality ऐसी बनाई कि मैं जो भी करूँगा ethical करूँगा, तो आपके पेरेंट्स देखेंगे और बोलेंगे कि भाई ये कर रहा है, ये ठीक कर रहा है, इसके इसको अपोज नहीं करते. ना ही आपके पेरेंट्स, आपके बाजू वाले, आपके लोग, बाकी के दोस्त लोग भी बोलेंगे कि ये जो कर रहा है सही कर रहा है। कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कहाँ पे आता है? कॉन्फ्लिक्ट जब आता है कि उसको पेरेंट्स को लगता है कि यार इसका ठीक नहीं होगा, अरे अच्छी तरह से नहीं चलेगा, अरे ये ऐसा नहीं होगा, ऐसा नहीं, ये इसमें थोड़ा सा मुनाफा नहीं आएगा। पर आप जब उनको पेरेंट्स को समझता है ये अनकॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग बंदा है, ये पागल बंदा है, ये मर जाएगा पर एथिकल चीज करेगा, तब तो आपसे आप कोई मुंह नहीं लगेगा।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई एम गोइंग टू कम टू पब्लिक नाउ क्वेश्चन। लेकिन कभी कभी फादर उल्टा भी सोचता है कि इतना ईमानदार है कि धंधे ही चौपट कर देगा। वो भी एक चैलेंज है। यस, ओपन टू पब्लिक नाउ प्लीज।
यस, एनीवन वुड लाइक टू पुट फॉरवर्ड क्वेश्चंस, प्लीज रेज योर हैंड्स।
ये माइक जो यहाँ पे है पब्लिक को हम पहुँचा सकते हैं। प्लीज आज जब तक मौका नहीं। आई एम, आप सीधे भी क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं पैनल से, और बी शॉर्ट बिकॉज हमारा टाइम खत्म हो रहा है, लेकिन हम चाहते हैं जितना हो सके कवर
करें। प्लीज, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम थैंकफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू, given a very good suggestion, and you are highly qualified and experienced people. But you people have clearly said to do the business, your loans are available, everything, you have given good expertise. But what we are lacking in the business, the first important thing we require is the guts. Guts and the confidence. The most of the time you are saying that loans are available, we can get the finance, but the first of all, nowadays in India we are facing a modern problem. Problem we are facing, but we are facing a modern problem nowadays. To get a loan also is not that easy, sir. They have put lot of restrictions on that, sir. Especially the big people can get crores of rupees and all, but the small people want to open account also. Lot of problem coming in that. The second thing is that the lot of competition is there in the business. To survive in the business is not that easy. The another important point I would like to raise is that our government taxation problem is too much. It's not that easy. Most of the time the people are running away from the taxes, they are not paying. Why? Bolte na chori kar lo acha. Because a lot of taxation problem is coming, and one of the practical thing I would like to bring, no doubt may not suit you, may not people like it. वो बोलते हैं ना कि लोग गवर्नमेंट ही सीख जाते थे अपने पैसा कैसे अपने को ही चोरी करने का। सॉरी टू से दिस थिंग ब्लंटली, बट द थिंग इज दैट द टैक्सेशन ऐसा निकला है कि आदमी बहुत फंस जाता है सब जगह पैसा है। इज देयर एनी अदर सोल्यूशन फॉर दैट? Whatever the business you do, without giving the rishwat, we cannot go ahead in the business also. Everywhere the government got the policy aisa ke jo bhi aata hai usko to kuch dena hota hai. So honestly, people are saying honesty is the best policy, but nowadays I've come across the honesty is the worst policy over here. Sorry to say this thing.
Thank you very much. We have to be thoughtful to other people also. Of course, we appreciate your concerns, and there is no dispute that, you know, about honesty and importance of integrity, etc. But you will have enough time to interact during the break. But please allow them to ask questions. Yes, please. Two people sit behind. Yeah. Yeah. One after another. One, two, three. Yeah, please.
What more scope is for, since it's for MSME, something. Prior to my this lending assignment, I walked in a dedicated rating agent.
Please keep the mic a little closer, yeah, because you're not here.
Yeah, about the father and son thing. Prior to my this lending assignment, I walked in a dedicated rating agency, Esmera.
Mm-hmm.
So, where we rated around 20,000 SMEs. One of the success mantra in SMEs, what we have seen, is the presence of father and son duo working together. So 95% of the SME which was doing good and which got highest rating from our agency had father and son duo working together. So if father is not able to sell his business idea to his son, then selling outsider is different. Similarly, if son is not getting purchased and brought into the business, and if they are working together, then it's a sure sort of the way now we look at is if the father and son duo working is there, we know that this business is good. It's going on good way. So
thank you.
Just view on that also.
Okay. So I agree with your point of view that if the father or son duo is working together, then the SME stands a better chance and gets a better credit rating. And this is also in line with partly answers some of your first question, that what are the lending opportunities or debt opportunities kind of thing available for these SMEs. So the reason why some of these SMEs do not get the loans, that's because they don't have the bank history, they don't have the credit history. There's a lot of talk about their accounts are not kept properly, etc., etc. But thankfully, in today's world, there are companies who have come up who do kind of a, what they call 360-degree check. So they look at their accounts, but they go far beyond looking at your accounts. They do some social media. They do some other forms of slicing and dicing. So I can take few names, like Capital Float is there, NDP is there. I think Esmera is also working with some of these agencies, and you'd be aware of them. And these companies do give loans to SMEs. It's just that the cost of funding there is much higher. And that's why we did not really talk much about it.
Yeah.
You'd like that?
Let me just add a perspective on father-son duo that you referred. So any investor would not blindly just believe that because father and son are working together, he will finance it. Yeah, so it's also classically can be compared with multiple co-founders in a business. As long as there is a collaboration, there is one person complementing the other because strengths and weaknesses of each other are different, because that qualitative aspect of working together is extremely important as opposed to just relationship that this is father, this is son working together. I think that plays a very important role in terms of decision making from the financier side.
Thank you. One closing.
I don't take any more of your time, but since you mentioned honesty is the best policy, I can't stop myself. So, you know, I used to smoke cigarettes. How many of you are smoking cigarettes?
Nobody.
Just a few. Okay, so to stop cigarette smoke karta tha main. Aur cigarette smoking stop karne ke liye mujhe tamaku chalu karni padi. Fir ye dono mujhe sir nazar aa gaya ek din, samajh mein aa gaya ki are main har roz subah uthta hu aur jo diwal hoti hai na, उसको मैं माथा उसके ऊपर खुद का माथा ये कर रहा हूँ और खून आ रहा है बाहर. ये समझने के लिए बहुत टाइम लगा. तो आप जिस बिजनेस में हो, उस बिजनेस में अगर आपको ये दिक्कत आ रही है कि ऑनेस्टी की बात आ रही है, तो फिर आप गलत बिजनेस में हो. आपको थोड़ा सा एथिकल तो होना ही चाहिए, पर थोड़ा सा होशियार भी होना चाहिए. जहाँ पर आपको एक्सपर्टीज नहीं हो, वहाँ पर क्यों जाते हो? इतने सारे एरियाज हैं जहाँ पर आप जा सकते हो. बट ठीक है.
Hello. Hello. Good afternoon, friends. I shall go to the core question. You see, if a person is a businessman, well experienced, is giving a good minimum 40% rise in business and everything, and now he wants to acquire one company, but it's a private limited company, he approaches to the bank. Bank says that we never provide the funds for buying the shares, because first we have to buy the shares and then you can become the owner and then place the property. So nobody is willing to finance you, or they ask for the collateral security. The person is having these with the first company. He has taken the loan from the company. And he paid back the loan within half a period. His performance is excellent, giving minimum 40% rise in business, which is, and there is no default in any function. But still, bank refuses to give him the funds because it is a private limited and they cannot finance to buying the shares of that company. And he is willing to place the property of the company once the shares is taken. He said, simultaneously you can make the contract, you can make the papers, we can sign that, but bank refuses to do that. Then in that case,
how he can raise the funds. You may say that you have to go to the Tata Finance or XYZ Finance Company, but it has been observed that they too ask for a collateral security. Then in that case, how he can raise the funds?
Okay.
Thank you.
We will have all these questions before I come back to my time. I'm running short of time. I'm so sorry. I have to finish it on time. I'm already 6 minutes late. So next one.
Hello.
Okay, very specifically. We connect investors and entrepreneurs with their presentation. So what I've seen is like whenever entrepreneur is showing their presentation to investor, they have 15 to 20 minutes generally. Like they get. And what exactly investor want to see in that presentation? I want to understand from you.
Good. Next one. Yes.
Myself Tahir. We are dealing in food processing business. My question is, at early stage of business, what we do planning and prediction, all these things. But what exactly has happened is totally different, because at initial phase, there are lots of challenges and problems happening in the business. So if we raise the fund, we deal with funders like the way what we plan, but exactly what is not happened, then how to deal with them. And at that stage, we need more funds after that crisis, then how could arise more fund?
Yeah, hi sir. My name is Feroz. I started this company called Future Promotion Events. It's a marketing and event company in 13-14. So, you know, we face lots of corruption, you know, when dealing with clients. You know, we have to bribe in marketing and, you know, in accounts. So lots of, you know, I want to ask this question to Mr. Kunte when we talk about transparency and honesty. And also when we go to banks and all, you know, 10 days back, one bank told me, you know, they are giving us a loan, you know, a 10 lakh rupees loan. But, you know, when they called me, they were asking for a bribe, you know, 3 to 4%. So what should we do? You know, like corruption is everywhere, you know, like in the private sector. So for the banks, you know, like a startup for like us. So we face, you know, such kind of a challenges.
Thank you.
The fundraising is the most important activity for MSME. But the issue always comes with regard to collateral securities. Many a times, with not having enough collateral securities, there is a delay in funds, and which leads to downsizing of the business. So what are the ideas which they can do, how to cut short or cut down the cost, or which areas to be looked into for getting this collateral security?
I will answer some of the questions and then my co-panelists can add on that. So the first question was, I think, about how do we get some funding for acquisition. Indian banks generally do not allow end use as an acquisition. Foreign banks do, but obviously that funding is not available. What I have seen people doing is they take as a promoter funding or something as a loan against property or something. It is understood that money is fungible and that is used for the acquisition. So it is understood that those funding will not be a low cost funding. Generally, the cost of funding could be even 16 to 18% or higher. But more often than not, it is an unsecured, so you don't really have to give additional collateral for that. The next question was about the problems faced in
corruption.
Corruption.
Prediction and planning.
Okay, prediction and planning. So when you go for a funding, you go with a base case scenario, what we call is a base case scenario. You assume that you are doing, let's say, 20 crore of business today. You assume that I will grow at X percent. In 3 years down the line, I'll be whatever, 20 plus so many X percent. So going is never as good as what you make it out to be. It will never be. Abhi tak to maine nahi dekha. So you, either you do X plus delta or you do X minus delta. More often than not, promoters in India are an optimistic lot. So jo project karte hain, usse kam hi perform karte hain. But there's nothing to be really apologetic about. Agar kuch hua hai, jiske wajah se aapki performance kam ho gayi hai, like I said earlier also, be transparent, be upfront about it. Haan, maine ye project kiya tha, for these, there has to be some good reasons for that. For these reasons, I have not been able to perform. I had told you I will reach 30, I will reach 25 only. But I have identified these are the problem areas and I'm addressing it and I'm just cooking up this story for you. आपको ये बताना होगा कि मैंने ये steps लिए हैं वो करने के लिए. And then if the investor is comfortable, he only will fund you more, or maybe you can go out and get funding from some other places. I think the third question was about the ethics, or will you add on that?
Sorry, I will just pitch on the investor deck question that you had. So, as I mentioned earlier, the investors have standard questions to ask to understand the business, right? We can encompass on what's the value proposition that we have. Yeah, what's the value proposition that you have? What kind of problem you're solving and how this can be turned into a business model? Secondly, what is the addressable market that you're talking about, right? So today you may be having a market share. So do you have a market share scenario built into your business? The business model that I spoke about earlier, how do you, you know, grow the revenue? How do you control expenses and how do you make profits and cash? What are the business challenges that you are facing? What is the competition? And what is the use of funds? You are seeking funds from an investor. So how are you going to use it? And what are the, you know, plan B in case something goes wrong? So if you go to net search, there are standard decks available and you can, you know, get going on that, and we can also touch upon this during the lunch break. I think the second question again was about the planning versus reality, right? So A, when we make the plan, it has to be realistic. The base case that Fazal mentioned about is extremely important. It cannot be a superlative aggressive, you know, planning. Secondly, I think I go back to the point of meat, the T that you're talking about, trust, right? There is always a reality which is going to be different. As long as you have done your best to counterattack the, you know, wild world's reality, I think as long as the trust factor is there between the investor and you, the investor himself will fund more, or he can, you know, guide you to seek funds from somebody else. So establishing that trust factor is extremely important. And there will always be differences. So every one of us faces that, right? We think of something, but because all things are not in our control, things are going to be different. But the trust equation will help you solve that problem.
ये बहुत सारे सवाल हैं. आपने इसका इनका बुक देखा है क्या? आपको ग्रामीण बैंक पता है क्या? तो प्रोफेसर मोहम्मद यूनुस भी पता रहेंगे, तो उनका उनका किताब जरूर पढ़ना, क्योंकि आपका जो ऑनेस्टी का क्वेश्चन है वापस जो था ना, करप्शन है सर. सो ग्रामीण बैंक्स हियर और मेनी ऑफ द बैंक्स, नॉट जस्ट इन इंडिया, इन द यूएस आल्सो, मेनी ऑफ द जो हमारा डेवलपमेंट का मॉडल है ना, वही उल्टा पुल्टा हो गया है. बराबर है, जो बैंक में किसको क्रेडिट देते हैं जिसको क्रेडिट की जरूरत नहीं है. ग्रामीण बैंक ने उस मॉडल को उल्टा कर दिया. ग्रामीण बैंक में वो किनको देते हैं क्रेडिट? जिनको रियली गरज है. ओके, सो ये जो है ऑनेस्टी का जो सवाल है, राइट? सो यू हैव टू बी स्मार्ट अबाउट इट. यू हैव टू बी स्मार्ट. आप ग्रामीण बैंक का किताब पढ़ना एंड टू एंड. ओके, और प्रोफेसर मोहम्मद यूनुस के ऊपर भी पढ़ना कि उन्होंने क्या क्या किया है. और ऐसे बहुत सारे एग्जाम्पल्स है. यूनुस का तो इतना बड़ा नाम हो गया, अभी वो लोग यहाँ पे इंडिया में भी काम करते हैं. आप साउथ बॉम्बे में उनका ऑफिस है मोहम्मद यूनुस का, मोहम्मद यूनुस फाउंडेशन, ग्रामीण फाउंडेशन. आप उनसे जाके मिल लेना, वो जून में आने वाले हैं.
थैंक यू वेरी मच माय पैनलिस्ट. प्लीज गिव हिम गिव देम अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लाउज फॉर अ टाइम. एंड आई एम पर्सनली ग्रेटफुल टू ऑल ऑफ देम फॉर स्पेंडिंग देयर टाइम एंड शेयरिंग देयर एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड थॉट्स विद अस. एंड फ्यू टेक अवे, जो बात आई है कि एक तो ये आई कि आप अपने बिजनेस को खुद समझें, ज़रूरत से पहले और ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा की उम्मीद ना करें, क्योंकि वो आपके ऊपर कहीं ना कहीं बाद में जा कर के एक खर्चा पड़ेगा. अपने बिजनेस की अकाउंटिंग को सही रखें, अपने ऊपर ट्रस्ट करें, और थोड़ा सा स्मार्ट बनने की कोशिश करें. जो क्या है कि ईमानदारी खुद ही स्मार्टनेस सिखाती है, क्योंकि अगर हर जगह झूठ बोलने से काम हो जाए तो स्मार्ट लोग नहीं होंगे फिर तो, बिकॉज झूठ से काम चल रहा है. लेकिन झूठ नहीं बोलना है, देन इट pushes you to find another way of, you know, meeting your objective without being on the wrong side of the, you know, behavior. So with this few words, thank you very much to the organizers. Thank you very much to the Octaware company, and thanks everyone for joining us. Thank you very much.